Hi, Elaine here. Today, I'll be showing you how to make your own custom shapes for use in your presentations. And to do that, we'll be using a completely new feature of PowerPoint 2016 for Mac. And that completely new feature is the Merge Shapes option. It's been in PowerPoint for Windows since Office 2013, and now it's available in the Mac version. To understand how it works and just how powerful it is, let's have a quick look at the PowerPoint shapes. You'll find the PowerPoint shapes available from the Home ribbon and the Shapes button in there. As you can see, there's an extensive range of shapes included, but it's not definitive. They are editable to some degree as well, but we'll look at that down the line. So, very simple to use. You click the shape you want in that drop-down and then draw the shape out. If you would like a perfect square, you can do exactly the same again, but holding down the Shift key and you get a proportional shape. So very, very simple to use. Just go back and keep picking the one you want and drawing it out. You can also go into the shapes and choose a shape and just click once on the slide and that will add that shape to the slide. And one final one for good luck, because we will be seeing this one in a moment. Okay, so there are the basic shapes, but basic does not have to mean boring. We have a look at this slide. It's very, very simple. It's just got a heading, an image, and some text. But with the addition of some simple shapes, it's a much more powerful slide. And the only difference there is the addition of 5 circles and 5 lines relating to those circles, and one final line, which is the yellow one going across the slide at the bottom. And here's another slide with some very simple shapes, just a few rectangles, and you've got an effective timeline. And they really are just rectangles. There's one going the full width, that is the timeline. There are circles on the top of that, of each individual point, and just one other shape. And that's it. And it's very, very effective. But we're interested in custom shapes. And this is when the built-in shapes just don't cut it. And you've got several options when it comes to making custom shapes in PowerPoint. You can draw shapes. You can edit shapes, you can group shapes to create composite shapes, and you can also use the new option, which is the Merge Shapes command. You may also hear those referred to as Boolean operations. So let's start with the drawing shapes. And to do that, you've got 3 special tools available: the Curve tool, the Freeform tool, and the Scribble tool. Now, they are all located in the shapes drop-down, hiding in plain sight, as it were. They look identical to the basic shapes, but they're more customizable. So opening up that drop-down, these are the shapes that you have. We've seen some of those. But over here on the right-hand side, that option there is the Curve tool. And then there's the Freeform tool, and then there is the Scribble tool. So let's have a look at the Curve tool first of all. Now, with the Curve tool, you click where you want the curved line or the shape to begin. And then you click where you want the first turn in the curve to appear. The straight line turns into a curved line and it bends around the point that you clicked. As you move the mouse, the bend of the curve changes. You click to add more turns to the curve. Each time you click, a brand new bend is added to the line and you just keep clicking until the line is as curved and as twisted as you need. To finish a line, double click where you want the end of the curved line to appear. And to create a closed shape, double click over the starting point. Right, the next tool is the Freeform tool. So getting a new slide and going back to the shapes and selecting that Freeform tool. The Freeform tool is a bit of a hybrid. It can draw straight lines, but also freeform lines. So to draw a straight line, you click with the left mouse button and release the mouse button. As you can see, you get a preview there of a straight line. You click once, you get a straight line. That's how it draws straight lines. Click, release, move the mouse, click, release, move the mouse. But you can also choose to hold down the left mouse button and draw. And as you do, you get a curved freeform line. And I just missed closing that there. So there we go, a very different shape. Now, the problem with that is it's not as accurate. It's only as steady as your hand is. And the next one is the Scribble tool. So back up to the shapes, select Scribble tool. And what you've got in here is drawing with the Scribble line tool is almost the same as the Freeform line tool. There's just a few key differences. First of all, you don't need to double click to create an end point for the line with the Scribble tool. So I'm just drawing there. What I'm not doing is releasing the mouse pointer. There is a reason that I'm not doing that. So very similar, but I didn't need to double click. And also, once you start drawing with the Scribble tool, you cannot release that mouse button until you finish drawing. If you did, it would stop the drawing. So just to have a look at that, back into the tool there, just draw around and then let go. And as soon as you let go, you have your shape. That's it. That point where you release the mouse button will be the end point for the drawing. So all three of these tools, they're a bit time consuming. They would all benefit from you having existing expertise or putting in a few hours practice. So we need a much better way. Let's move on to creating custom shapes by editing shapes. First thing we need is a few shapes. So just getting a few very, very simple shapes here. And we'll also have in there that one. Try and get that perfect circle holding down the shift key. And how about the smiley face there? Right, let's have a look what we've got in here. Well, first of all, you'll see on a very basic shape, there is no edit points other than scale. So all of the points that are available on that shape are white. But if I go and get a different one, so I'm going to get the cross in here and draw a cross out. This time there's a special handle on there, which is a yellow point. And clicking on that yellow point changes the actual shape. So very, very different effect there. That would be nice as a background. So looking at the other shapes, some have more than one yellow handle. And this one here can create quite a nice effect if you use the rotate tool, move it round, and then use the yellow points just to change the cutout of that pie there. And we've got something that looks like a Pac-Man. Now, this smiley face also has a yellow handle. And yes, it's on the mouth there. So happy at the moment, but you can make it a very sad shape. So with the built-in shapes, it's a matter of having a look at all of the shapes and investigating what kind of options you have for editing those. Now, that was done using just the built-in simple edit points. But you can also edit in a more advanced way. So moving back to the Pac-Man here. The yellow edit points are very obvious, but there are other edit points that are less obvious. So making sure that you're on the shape format and across on the left hand side, you have a button in there and you can choose to change the shape, which will just completely change this shape into another shape. But the option that we're interested in is the edit points option. And going into edit points, and you now have the white handles removed, the yellow handles have disappeared, but you now have a collection of black edit points. All of these black points can be moved individually and independently from each other. So just clicking and dragging that one moves it away. We'll drag that out a bit. And what you should notice is as you select each individual point, you also see two blue lines coming off it and handles on the end of those. What they enable you to do is alter the effect of the curve. So each of these tends to be curved and that will alter the look of the curve. So widen that out up there and narrow it down there at the bottom. In fact, let's widen that out a little bit more. There we go. Now, that is using the points that are already there. If you want to change the shape more radically, you hover over the edge of the shape and right click, you can add a point. And that will give you another point that you can move independently and drag out as required. And if you want to delete a point, right click on it and delete the point. And then you may need to alter that slightly to get the shape that you're looking for. So there we go. That's using the advanced edit points option. But there's an even easier way, and that is using grouping and merging. Now there's much overlap with grouping and merging, but also some very important differences. So let's take a look at those differences now. What we've got here are two identical shapes, two on the left and two on the right. What I'm going to do is just group those together on the left, and you can do that with right click and group, or you can use the shortcut key Command Option and G. So they're grouped, and I'm going to merge these two. And your merge options are all available in the Shape Format ribbon. And over on the left hand side, they're available from that button. And you have five of them. We'll look at them in detail in a minute. I'm just going to select Union, which is really the equivalent of grouping, but in a slightly different way. With these shapes, very little difference. No difference at all, really. I can move the shapes. They look the same. No difference at all. Functionally, there is, So let's have a look at that. If the shapes were different colours and I wanted to group them, so Command, Option and G, they retain all their formatting, but choose identical shapes and go back and union them, so merge the shapes, and the background shape loses its colour. So colours are retained in groups but lost in merge operations. So let's just go down to another slide and do exactly the same again and get a different effect this time. So this one's going to be grouped, Command, Option and G. And these two shapes on the right are going to be merged. So shape format, merge shapes and union. And despite the fact they were the same colour, we have got two different results. On the left hand side, the grouped shapes are two distinct shapes locked together in one group. Over on the right hand side, we have a completely new shape. So the border goes all the way around the edge of the new shape. And at the bottom, where there is a reflection, it's a completely different shape reflection to the what you would see in a group on the left. Just the way those shape operations work. Merging makes a completely new shape, rather than grouping, which temporarily treats different shapes as a single entity. Now, there are different ways that you can use the merge shapes option. So, onto another slide. There are five options. Union, combine, fragment, intersect, and subtract. So let's have a look what each one does. Well, we've seen union already. What that one does is create a completely new shape. It encompasses both of the source shapes. Combine does something very different. It joins the shapes together, completely merged. You do get a single new shape, but the areas where the original shapes intersect are completely removed. So you'll see in the middle there is a gap. On to fragment. So select those shapes and up to format, down to fragment. There is one slight difference. That's the only visible difference. A border has appeared along the bottom of the rounded rectangle. But just to show you what has actually happened, you now have multiple shapes. It's not a single shape. As I pull these shapes away, you can see that what fragment does is take all of the shapes and where they intersect, create a new shape from it. Right, intersect. Let's have a look what intersect does. Up to merge shapes and down to intersect. This is the reverse of combine, really. It does create a single new shape, but areas where the original shapes intersect are the only areas that remain. So the majority of the rounded rectangle and the arrow have disappeared. The only bit that's left is where they intersected. And finally, we have subtract. So select those again and subtract. And what that does is create a single new shape. The upmost shape in the stacking order is removed from the lowest shape in the stacking order. So the arrow was over the top of the rounded rectangle. It's removed the arrow and it's also removed where it intersected with the rounded rectangle. Now, what does all that mean for you when it comes to creating custom shapes? Well, I've got six shapes here. These were just shapes that I found in the shapes dropdown, and I've just added them here for speed. And what I'm going to show you is what you can do in terms of making custom shapes. Quite frequently on slides, you need to show gender. And what I'm doing here is creating the male and female gender shapes. So just moving these shapes into place. And there we go. Now you can see, if I were to group these, they wouldn't look great because they've all got borders on. That's why I need to use these new merge options. So shape format and merge and union and select all the shapes there again and union. And we've got two new complete shapes. Now they were relatively simple. Let's try a trickier one. All I have here are four rectangles and a triangle. And what I'm going to do is move them into position and then use the merge shapes. So that one needs to be a little bit bigger and put that one up there and finally the other rectangle. I think you've got a shrewd idea what that is already, but what I'm going to do is use some of the merge shapes operations and finish the job. So up to merge shapes and down to subtract. And that gives us a window and a door. And the next thing to do is to Command and A to select all of the remaining shapes, back to Shape Format, back to Merge Shapes, and this time Union what is remaining. And we have our house symbol. And a final demonstration, just to show you how simple it is to create some really useful shapes. So let's make a map pin. Very, very simple. Over to Shapes, and this time choosing the teardrop shape. Clicking there and holding the Shift key, because I do want it equal, and dragging it out. Now rotate it, and I'm holding the Shift key down so it snaps in its rotation so I can get it at 135 degrees. Using the yellow pin and drawing that out. And to make a map pin, I just need one more shape, which is a circle. Put that about in the right place, holding the Shift key down, and then centering it. I'm going to put a fill in there. So this time I want a white fill in there. And then Command and A and just group those shapes together. And I have a blue map pin. What I'm now going to do is copy and paste that so I have two of them. And I'm just going to change the colour. So going into that shape, and that brings up the format shape options. I want to change the fill. It's already a solid colour, but it's blue. And I'm going to make that green. Then it is simply a matter of copying them. Command and C. Moving on to the next slide, which already has a map available. Pasting them on there and scaling them. So they're a little bit big. So take the scale down. And that was just made out of two shapes and a group. So very, very simple to do, but quite effective for your presentations. Let's put that one up there. So let's recap. Custom shapes, lots of options. In addition to the basic shapes, you've got three tools, the curve tool, the freeform tool, and the scribble tool. You have options to edit points, either using the simple yellow handles or a more complex method using the actual vector points that make up the shape. Then we went on to merging and grouping. Grouping is a more temporary solution for treating multiple shapes as a single shape. Each shape retains its own properties, including the colour and the styles. Merging shapes, which is the new feature, creates a completely new shape from the individual shapes that you've merged. And the merge shapes options that you have, all again new to PowerPoint 2016 for Mac, are Union, Combine, Fragment, Intersect and Subtract. And they allowed us to make much more complex shapes from the basic shapes using just the merge types available. Well, I hope that helps you. And if you want new tutorials and tips and tricks on a regular basis, check out my free training at elainegiles.com/VIP. And if you enjoyed this video, then give it a thumbs up. And I always appreciate it when you share it with your friends. If you have any requests for specific tutorials, be sure to contact me. I would love to hear from you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.